And welcome inside our broadcast booth here inside the SAGU Sports Network. We're perched high above the gymnasium preparing for game two of our doubleheader. Lions won the first one in big fashion. What was it, like 95-54? It was a big win for the Lady Lions. Talk about this DCC team. They come into this ballgame 9-9 in the season, 1-5 in their conference. Lions coming off a nice win against JBU just a few nights ago. They improved to 3-3 in the season. They're 12-5 overall, John.
Not a bad basketball team. Different classing going on here, so I would expect that SAGU is going to, you know, win decisively. Not a blowout, but decisively is what I expect. We already played them once, and we won that game handily up there in their arena.
Let's go down to the field now and check in with Adam Ferguson, who's standing by with head coach Donnie Bostwick. Adam?
Thank you, Rob. I'm here with head coach Donnie Bostwick. Now, you just came off two big wins against Oklahoma Baptist and then John Brown this past broadcast we were out. Now, what do you have to say about tonight in a non-conference game? We're trying to get a different schedule.
The reason we do this is the national tournament's 5 games in 6 days, and so playing 5 games in 8 days, taking a trip to Africa, taking a trip to Florida, the travel, all that kind of stuff. It's all just preparation, hopefully, for a national tournament. And that's why we do it. These guys, they beat Jarvis Christian recently, played OBU within 10. Actually played them a 9-point game right before Christmas. So they're a pretty good team.
Now, last game out, we saw a breakout performance by Rashad Alexander. He had about 27 points and a bunch of beautiful assists. Now, what do you have to say about this junior who came in from Chicago? What do you have to say about so far in the season?
You know, I expected it. He's a really good player. He was a region junior college player of the year. You know, I just finally getting in rhythm with our team, and he's the most unselfish. If one not, you know, him and Jason Gentry are probably two most unselfish players as wise, assist wise and stuff. So, you know, I just expect a different guy every night, and Rashad's got the ability to do that. So I'm looking forward to more of that, actually.
Now, he also, we just found out he was named the Sooner Athletic Conference Player of the Week. I don't know if he knows it. I don't know if you guys know it, but we just found out. What do you think that means to him and to you as a coach to have him represent the Sooner Athletic Conference from your team?
You know, we look at rankings and honors like that for the fans. That's a team award. You know, he wins it, I win it and stuff. So it's a big honor. It's a great thing and stuff. But, you know, like I said, John Walters won it earlier, you know. And so we have two team awards right now, you know, and that means we played good that week.
All right, well, good luck, Coach, and we'll go back to you, Rob.
Wow, Player of the Week, Rashad Alexander, one of your favorite players. Good to see him awarded for his outstanding play against JBU. Check one stat on that. The Crusaders are actually 8-14 on the season. I got that mixed up with the women's team. These Crusaders are 8-14 on the season and 4-0 in conference play. A few players to look out for today for the Crusaders, I think, is going to be Trent Dawson. Averages 14 points a night, 48 rebounds on the season. Josh Harris averages 11, 43% from the field. And then God's Power Igben, I think I said that name right, God's Power Igben, 103 rebounds, big man inside, 13 blocks.
That's a little scary, Rob, having God's Power.
I don't want to do that. He's a 6'9 freshman from Nigeria. Now, the Lions counter with their own African connection in one of my favorite players, Emmanuel Adoy. So he'll be matched up at some point with God's Power Igben. Adoy, 115 rebounds on the season, a few more than God's Power, 23 steals, 11 blocks. So these two match up really well. Adoy stands 6'5", a junior, and like we said, Igben, a 6'9", freshman from Lagos, Nigeria. For the Lions, also look for Rashad Alexander to have another good game. He averages 14.5, shooting 50% from the field. And how about Jonathan Walter, the senior? 0 points by halftime against JBU. We knew he'd break out. He did. Ended up with 16 on the night. Exceeded his average of 14.9 a game. He's got 92 rebounds, 36 steals, shoots 51% from the field. There he is. As he goes, essentially, so goes the Lions, and now begin to add to that mix this player of the week in Rashad Alexander, who's just been shooting lights out on fire against JBU a few nights ago. This team ranks number one in the nation in steals per game with 14.5. Total steals, 246 on the season. Ranked number five to the Lions in the nation in offensive rebounds per game with 15.7 a game. And also number nine in the nation in assists per game with 17.1, led by Jason Gentry with 67 assists, Guidry the senior with 43, and Walter the swingman with 31 assists. As far as shooting percentage, Walter, we said over 51%, Rashad at 49, and Marcus Price, a new big man presence inside, shooting 48% from the field. And Price is quickly becoming an important player in the rotation, getting the start last couple of games. You see him right there next to Remington Mitchell. Price, a 6'6 junior, transfer from Mountain View College out of DeSoto High School. And what is it with DeSoto High School and the Lions? We've got three from the Lady Lions, and we have Marcus for the Lions. And he, John, has become a huge presence inside for Coach Boswick, has Price.
Well, DeSoto's a local high school to us, so it's kind of natural connection for us. We are all in the South DFW, and Coach Boswick has made some special friends with some of the coaches in the area, and really takes their word for what kind of player. And it takes a special player to come here to SAGU. Not only do they have to be athletically qualified, but there's a academic qualification and a spiritual qualification that needs to happen. So we're not just getting a one-dimensional person per se. You've got to be much more than an athlete to come play here at Southwestern Sinuous God University.
I'm here to keep track of all of the social media happenings on our various websites and social media sites. We got you on Twitter. We got you on Facebook. We got you on the YouTube channel as well as Instagram. If you want to give us your guaranteed win in the Sooner, you can give it a shot right now.
My first guaranteed win is Patriots over the Seahawks by 23.
It's already begun. We're 2 weeks out. 2 weeks out. He's already started. Gotta hear it every day from this guy.
Every day. You better believe it, buddy. I had to hear it all week. Here we go with the starting lineups for Dallas Christian Crusaders.
Trent Dawson, 6'3", sophomore from Dallas. Get the start. The guard. Also will be Anthony McQuarrie, number 22, freshman from Cairns, Texas. Derek Hearns also doing the nod, a sophomore from Detroit, Michigan. And also Travis Martain. And finally, Trey Lindsey rounds out the starting five for the Crusaders. Now, John, you've made a big point before. It almost doesn't really matter who starts for the Lions, because in about 5 minutes we'll probably see a complete line change. But it's nice to see, you know, who the starters are. But really, the minutes are so dispersed out. And that's just one thing that Boswick does every season he's been here.
And that's one of the exciting things about watching the SAGU Lions play is Coach Boswick, he will get a regular five going. It doesn't have to be that way. Every player on the team knows it doesn't have to be that way. But sometimes, you know, it just kind of works out. Here's the best chemistry on the floor from practice. So, and usually there's a consistent five that happens. But ultimately, as the game begins to evolve, Donnie Boswick is much like Bill Belichick in the fact that it's produce. Just produce. Do your job. Produce, and you will get to play. And if everyone's producing, well, then you'll see on the stat sheet there's an equal distribution of minutes. But that's how you play in the Donnie Boswick system.
I'm going to ask Adam right now what the over-under is on the number of times John Cooper's going to say Bill Belichick. We're already at two. I'm going to go with 6.
6 is undershooting it by a lot. I'm going to go ahead and say, in this game alone, 15. And I'm taking the over.
Notice how John is speechless. He has no words to say right now.
I'm not speechless at all, my friends.
Marcus Price will jump. And Miles Burnside, number 22 for the Crusaders. We are underway, and Marcus gets it over to Rashad Alexander on a Monday night MLK night here, bringing you Big Monday Basketball on the SAGU Sports Network. Rashad had 27 last time out here. Gets over to Gentry, younger brother of Caleb Gentry. Adoy looks inside to Price. Over to Walter. Adoy, triple team, looking for help. Spins, turns, loses the handle. Burnside comes away with it quickly in transition. Crusaders. It's Martain, the point guard. Lions. The man-to-man to begin the game. A long shot and a rebound cleared by Adoy. Quickly up ahead to Gentry. Near the top of the key, back to Adoy. Rashad, he can shoot from there if he wants to. Decides to give it over to Doy, quickly inside to Price. Back to it, Rashard. Baseline stops, turns into the paint, over to Gentry. 16 the shot clock, a whistle, and a foul called against the Crusaders. We'll keep it right here.
Well, as you see, the Crusaders are in high performance mode right now, and they're attacking the basketball, pushing the basketball on offense. They're going to try to play the same game as the Lions. They're just a very up-tempo, high up-tempo pace type game.
Price, the lefty, no relation to me, even though I'm a lefty, drains it from 15. Lions up 2-0. Boy, look at the speed around the left side from Martain.
Lots of speed.
And Rashad protects the ball with his body. Invites the contact, gets the contact, and he'll go to the line.
And I like the way he created some distance between his defender and the ball.
Looks at
stayed
defender.
With one hand, made himself as wide as possible.
Begging to be fouled.
Yeah, well, that's just a great veteran move. What you do is you slow up, keep the ball out in front of you as far away as possible, hoping that your defender will reach over you, and which is exactly what happened.
Alexander's free throw is good. Lines up 5-0. Derek Hearns from Michigan brings ball across the timeline. Shadowed by Gentry. Lindsay over to Martain. Dawson now into the paint. Finds Burnside. Too strong off the glass. Adoy clears. Price puts the ball on the floor. And that results in a turnover. And out of nowhere comes Rashad Alexander. And he somehow gets it off to Walter. Heads up play from Alexander. As he stole that pass under the basket. Really impressed by his pace of play. And an errant pass inside to Price. And off the glass and good. It's Trey Lindsay, number 23.
Well, Dallas Christian has come to play some basketball here at the Holy Dome in Waxahachie, Texas today.
Alexander, shadowed by Hearns, and a turnover.
Technically, that is not a double dribble. He had not established a dribble yet, so he could pretty much do whatever he wanted with the ball. That's just a bad call. That is anticipated call by the ref.
Burnside, the 6'5 senior from Houston, gets the ball inside the paint, guarded by Marcus Price. High shot, rebound, Adoy, and a foul on Travis Martain trying to wrestle out of Adoy's hands.
Well, while the Crusaders can play a very up-tempo type of game with the Lions, they still are not showing a lot of discipline with their hands. They're hacking, they're extending their arms over instead of straight up.
That's Martain's second foul. And you saw between the inbound, he turned to his coach and said, I'm okay. But it looks like head coach Charles Williams thinks otherwise. He's about to send God's Power Igben into the game, likely for Martain. We'll wait and see the next stoppage of play. But that's two on Martain early in the first 3 minutes of play here at the Schaefer Center. The Holy Dome, according to Mr. Cookman. And there's a whistle going strong at the basket. We'll send the Lions to the line. It'll be Alexander.
I'm impressed with the intensity of play by the Dallas Christian Crusaders. These guys, if they can keep up this kind of tempo.
Check that Dawson to the line. Go ahead.
Which they do have a significant bench, and if they can go that deep and keep this going, they may make this game interesting.
Dawson's free throw too strong off the glass. Adoy clears quickly across the timeline. Alexander looking inside, looking for Price. Tough pass picked off by Hearns. Dawson now goes baseline. Nice move. Loses the handle, but he gets bailed out by, I think that may have been, yeah, that's by Adoy. That's his second foul. And there's your line change, John. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players set the check in at the scores table.
And that's typical. You see all out 4 minutes of just put it out there. Leave it out there on the floor. Let's get another 5 guys to leave another 4 minutes. And as you see, over time, that will wear down the opponents. And it's going to be interesting to see how Dallas Christian is able to respond to fresh legs, fresh cardio coming at them.
They have to also quickly match up if they're going to go to a man, which we'll see here in a minute. They'll switch to a man. They got to make those decisions pretty fast, and they do come out in a man defense as the line change happens. And those decisions happen pretty fast. Beamster pops out to Erskine from three. Good, Erskine, great form, drains a three.
And that's a much-needed lift
from the wing.
Drew Erskine.
DCC tries a three. Loose ball. Feimster fighting for it. DCC comes up with it. Strong move to the basket. A whistle. I think it's going to be on the floor.
Yep.
Before the shot called against, I think it's Ramad Robertson, his first. He just checked into the game. Both teams have three fouls early on here, just 4 minutes into play. 8-5, your score. Lines up early. Had a 5-0 lead. Cut to three. Mitchell guarding Burnside. That one nearly fell through. Rims out, and now a whistle as Tyler Guidry is fouled on the loose ball. Guidry, the senior from Westbury Christian High School in the Houston area. Played behind Rambo for several years, and now leading the charge in this second unit. He's made some big shots over his 4-year career here at SAGU, that's for sure. Erskine now drives baseline. And ball stripped out of bounds. We'll keep it right here.
I'd like to see the great aggressive play by Drew Erskine.
That went off Erskine. Got a lucky call there. You see the replay. Clearly showed that was Erskine's foot. And a whistle. And they're going to wave it off.
Illegal pick on Remington Mitchell.
As
he will move. Yep, he moves in too. He's not established.
The no-no. Good eyes, Mr. Cookman. Seeing that one in live action.
Well, I assure you, you don't want me to ref a game.
And there's another whistle. This is going to go against the Crusaders. The charge. Against Trent Dawson, the sophomore from Dallas, Texas, and Guidry loses the handle and then tripped up. Robertson tripped up Igpen near the timeline. That's how quickly five fouls for each team. That's actually the second foul real quickly for Robertson. And a long three way downtown. Rolls in and out. Guidry spins it out and looking for Robertson, but the ball deflected. Turnover. Dallas Christian now a chance to tie with a three, or at least cut the lead to one. A strong move to the basket. Igpen will go to the line. Love that confident move around the right side. He was going. No one was going to stop him.
Well, I can tell you from what we've seen in almost 6 minutes of play, there is 120% confidence
that they can beat the Lions.
That they can play basketball.
Yeah, sure.
I don't even know that they're thinking about their opponent as much as we're just going to come out here and play basketball. The goal is to put the ball in the hoop and keep the other guys from scoring. In their mind, I don't know that they even see a nationally ranked contender of a team out there. They're just coming to play basketball, and they're playing hard and slashing to the basket, moving without the ball. A lot of excellent fundamentals going on here.
Jason's brother Micah's just checked in. He wears number 3, as has number 12, Josh Swearingen. Micah, younger brother of Caleb and younger brother of Jason, of course. And that could have been a goaltend, but it does go through.
Actually, he may have knocked it in.
He actually knocked it in.
It looked short.
Coach Boswick calls Micah the team's best shooter, the best pure shooter of the team, Micah Gentry.
I have shot with Micah Gentry, and I can tell you what, the kid is dead on.
Let's see if we can get some live action. He's in transition out up ahead. Feimster cut off the pass, looking now for answers. It's Erskine into the paint. Dishes off to Remington Mitchell, who's hacked from behind. No call. Nice move by Josh Swearingen. What an athletic play from Josh Swearingen coming off the bench, lining up the crowd. They're on their feet. Lions up 12-6.
The old Magic Johnson 360 spin.
Oh,
to the
an
left.
Pass from Burnside. And converting on the other end is Joshua Walls. Cut the lead back to 4.
Great, exciting basketball going on right now. A lot of intensity. This is a lot of fun to watch.
And a steal near midcourt and a whistle before Dawson can complete a fast break attempt.
I tell you what, I'm not going to want to see, if I'm Coach Boswick.
Look at that block.
I'm not going to want to see the turnover stat sheet. The Crusaders are forcing so many turnovers. Very intense defense. These guys are quick, fast, using their hands and their feet. Yeah. That's a dangerous combination. Most guys, you know, using their hands, but these guys use their feet and hands.
Dawson's free throw is good. One more coming. I don't think the Crusaders are going to go anywhere tonight. They're playing
well,
with these Lions.
I can tell you right now.
Look at the turnovers right there, 8-2.
If they were shooting any decent percentage from the field, they would be up by 10 right now.
Dawson gets both to fall. Swearingen will bring the ball across the timeline. He's a freshman from Arlington Martin High School. Over to Micah, looking for Mitchell. Cycles over to Swearingen. Inside to Feimster, the senior, pops it out to Erskine. Already has a 3. And a 3-second violation called.
You got to know where you are.
In the paint, and here comes 5 new players.
You got to know where you are on the court. That's inexcusable. Even though Erskine should have fired that right up as soon as he got it, this defense is stifling. It's just making the Lions think twice about every shot that they're actually taking. And if the refs let this kind of play happen and let the contact, which I agree with, then, you know, this ball game is not in the bag for the Lions at all.
You saw the stat there. Lions shooting 71%. Crusaders 20%.
I mentioned
they just have a 2-point lead.
Yeah, if they were shooting
that one,
you
falls.
Know, just twice as good as they have been shooting. They're up by 10.
Tough shot by Lindsay. We're tied, folks. 12 apiece with 12 seconds, or with 12 minutes and 12 seconds remaining. 12's wild. Walter now We know he'll make his statement. Oh, he had Gentry in underneath for just a flash of a second. Elected to pass it up, gave it to Adoy, and Adoy is fouled. Look at this move from Lindsay. Tough shot. Off the glass, kissing it off the backboard.
That's a fearless type of shot, man.
Oh, and a steal, a bad pass from Price. And finishing on the other end is Derek Hearns.
These guys
and a timeout on the floor, John.
These guys came to play basketball. They're showing Donnie Bostwick how Donnie Bostwick basketball should be played, because that's exactly what he's going to tell his team. This is supposed to be us. They're cutting off all passing lanes, collapsing. Their speed is putting them in an advantage where, you know, you just play hard and you just read the lanes.
This team is 4-0 in their conference, which tells you, can't confirm this, but they're likely on a four-game winning streak. You know, just as we are well into our conference, we're six games into our conference, they're likely at least four games into their conference.
Oh, yeah.
Well, they have to, because they're 4-0. So they're riding a four-game winning streak, although their record is 8-14. Don't be fooled. This team can play. And another turnover. Well, now they might change their mind. It looked like a turnover at first, but I'll tell you what, this team is on a roll right now, winning at least four straight.
Yeah, illegal pick was called.
That's going to send
a defensive pick. Actually,
that'll send Alexander to the line. Both teams now with seven fouls, a 1-1 for Alexander. He's become, I hate to say this word, but he's become, dare I say, money, even from the line. His form isn't my favorite, but he is consistent. That's what you want at the line. Gets that one to fall as well. Lions tie back up, and ooh, almost lost a handle. Darius Bogus, Walter, and rejected from behind by Bogus. Loose ball, Alexander, and a fight with Hearns.
That's the correct
keep
call.
Keep it right here.
That is the correct call. That was great, hard defense being played by the Crusaders, but they did touch it last.
Alexander with five early. Been quiet the last few minutes to those free throws. Gentry looking inside for an entry pass to Adoy. Not there. Price at the top of the key looking for Adoy. Gentry goes baseline, turns, spins, skip pass over to Alexander. Back inside to Adoy. Five on the shot clock.
Double down in the corner.
Price just beyond the free throw line. Tip. Live ball. They're going to say it landed on the line now. We'll keep it right here, but the Lions do get a fresh shot clock reset at 35 with 10:59 remaining in what's become a tight ball game quickly. And DCC is, like you said, they're here. They're not going anywhere. They want an upset win on the road tonight. Price, double team, back out to nice ball movement to Gentry from Walter. Tip, who wants it? And it's going to be DCC. Bogus on up ahead to Lindsay. Loses the handle.
Stays.
Keep it right here.
Well, this is fun basketball to watch. Not a whole lot of conversion, but when you get this high-paced intensity.
And there's a steal by Feimster. Finds Gentry. On up ahead to Alexander. Love the fact that Gentry didn't even dribble. Caught it in midair. Found the streak of Alexander filling the left lane. Alexander finishes it off.
That was a great pass. Great look by Gentry. He knows how to read the floor and see what's going on.
And a whistle out top. It's going to be either against Price or Gentry.
That's Marcus Price got caught with his hand in the cookie jar.
It's his first. That'll send Darius Bogus to the line. And that was a brick that went in.
Very fortunate.
I'm going to call it like I see it, my friends.
Well, that
was a good old-fashioned brick.
And he would just say shooter's touch. A lot of backspin on that. A lot of English.
That one also hit the back of the rim too strong. Walter clears. Gentry across the timeline. Loves to go all the way to the basket. Finds Walter from 10. Baseline no good. Too short. But Price comes up with the loose ball. Back to Walter. And love the body control, the protection off the glass. Jonathan Walter at his finest in the paint.
That's right. John Walter knows how to control the scenario, the situation with his body, that experience.
And a loose ball going up. Hearns lost the handle. Gentry, Feimster loves the three. Off the glass or off the back of the rim, no good. Cleared out by Hearn, by Bogus. And Lions clinging to a three-point lead with under 9:40 remaining, hanging in the air. And that shot's way short. Alexander now. Over in the corner to Gentry. Price turns, stops, pops. Too strong off the back of the rim. And that 71% percentage is going down in a hurry for the Lions. And there's a point blank layup missed by Hearns. Walter, stutter step, stop. Fouled going up.
Great recognition by John Walters to see that he had three guys on their heels. He could press into them and get the foul. Just initiate the contact. That's all you have to do. They're rocking back, so they're not solid in their position. No way for them to get a charge.
One and
you,
one.
As an offensive player, as an experienced offensive player, you've got to know that situation.
And Alexander stepped out of bounds right in front of the DCC bench. Turnover. Well, it wouldn't be turnover, it was a loose ball. Out of bounds to the Crusaders, and five new players check in. Mitchell, Erskine, Guidry, Robertson, and Swearingen has had an athletic play with a bucket early on off the bench. Burnside looked at a three and traveled. I believe it get him whistled for too many steps. Yeah, turn the ball back over to the Crusaders, to the Lions. Under nine remaining in an exciting non-conference game here on Monday night at the Schaefer Center.
Well, Dallas Christian's here to say that although they're in a lower class of a division, that doesn't mean a whole lot to them because they're at the top of their game in that division and can play in this division.
High. Look how high Robertson gets and elevates over the defender and drains the three.
Well, Ramad Robertson is lethal. If he gets a chance, he gets open and relaxed. He can reel off a bunch of points in a hurry.
And a whistle. God's power. Igben looking for the hoop in the harm, but he'll instead go to the line to shoot a one and one. That's the ninth team foul on the Lions. One more will put the Crusaders into the bonus. First free throw is good. The lead cut to five. Real active crowd here tonight. They're beginning to fill in for game two. Crowd, at least the student section, on their feet, most of them here at the Schaefer Center, cheering on these Lions. A game that doesn't count in the Sooner, but still, look at that elevation again from Robertson. Wow. How about the hustle from Erskine? Keeps it alive to Mitchell.
Well, that's both Erskine and Robertson crashing to the corner.
Erskine for three. Oh. No good. Long rebound. Here comes Hearns. Pulls it back, lets it fly, and misses the shot off the glass. And a turnover gives the ball back.
I mean, if there could be any execution and productive shooting for the Crusaders, this would be a different ball game.
We might be down by 15.
Yeah. These guys just cannot get the ball to drop in the hoop.
Not a good decision from Gidry, but he gets his own rebound and a whistle. Kind of bailed himself out there, John. Not a good decision. He was triple-teamed, got a shot off, got his own rebound, and went up again and got fouled. He got lucky.
And better than that, he got the referee in the blind spot. As you see, they come here. The referee can't see. He just saw 13 go up.
And that's uncharacteristic miss from Guidry.
In most cases, that's a no-call all day long.
Lefty second free throw, too strong again.
One thing I've noticed about the jungle, they have an interesting tradition with the way they cheer for their team. They actually throw the hex on their own player. Have you ever noticed? While the SAGU players are actually shooting free throws, the traditional hands up in the air. That's usually against the opponents, but not here, not in Waxahachie. It means something else.
And set to check into the game is a man you do not want to meet if he's hungry. 6'8", sophomore, 280-plus, Deion Rogers.
Hopefully,
Deion, what's for dinner, Rogers?
Yeah, hopefully they withheld lunch and dinner today.
He only attended the bed and breakfast. Northwood University. Oh, and a steal out ahead. Swearinger gets his pocket picked, and he tries to block it, and he does! But a putback heads-up play from Trent Dawson converts for the Crusaders. And a timeout on the floor, and Bostwick has seen enough. Not happy with either line change. Well, let's take you down now to the court side where we've got Adam Ferguson standing by. Adam?
Thanks, Rob. I'm here with Kelly Hill. Now, basketball season is in full swing here at SAGU for the varsity basketball teams, but another season starts on Thursday night. Now, Kelly, why don't you tell us what starts Thursday night here at SAGU?
Our intramural basketball starts on Thursday night.
Now, we know, and I don't know if they know, but our own color commentator, John Cookman, is actually stepping out to play with the Young Bucks in the SAGU Intramural League. Why don't you tell us what you think about him coming out on the court and playing with everybody?
John is pretty accurate. A little bit slow, but he's pretty accurate.
Well, thank you, Kelly. And we'll get ready for some more action here in the first half. But let's go back to you, Rob.
Emphasis on slow. Look at Kelly. Like, what am I supposed to say? Emphasis on slow.
Oh, my.
I
feel like I've been set up, but I can't say that she's wrong. And she was real generous in the whole accuracy thing, too. My.
Oh, my. She runs a great program out there at the Wellness Center. We're glad to have her on board.
Yeah.
She's got a whole bunch of intramural programs from fall semester through the spring, and plenty to do here.
Yeah, the intramural program has grown, 1,000% since she took over. And it's not just grown, but it is good. I mean, they have regional tournaments that they attend to.
Other schools.
Yeah, our flag football just did a regional tournament, which was held at TCU just down the road. But teams from all over Texas and New Mexico were involved.
Speaking of flag football, John, did I ever tell you the story of when your co-host secured the title for my team, Krause Third South at Evangel? Yes, I attended Evangel.
And
against my old floor, Burgess First North, in the fourth quarter with 5 seconds remaining, I got the game-saving flag snag and secured the title for my senior year with my floor.
The problem with that is
you told
that story in our last football broadcast.
It's always on my mind. You say intramurals, I go back to the glory days.
Well, I see our ratings going down as we speak.
Adam has rejoined us in the booth. Adam, thanks for an outstanding interview with Kelly. Let the truth be told. Came out.
I figured everyone needs to know what John Cookman's capable of against non-basketball playing college students.
And there's a college student player right there. Number one, Trent Dawson, drains a three.
It might be embarrassing to you students because I was the scoring champ when I was 45 years of age.
That's why I picked you up for my team, John.
That's pretty embarrassing.
Robertson
with a three from the corner.
Downtown.
Showing his lethal shooting ability.
Puts the lead back to one for the Lions. 6:20 remaining.
Now back to some real action.
Deion Rogers.
Deion Rogers.
Nice pass. Oh, and picked off.
Great pick.
By Martain. Outstanding play up in the air. Meanwhile, another three ball coming too short.
Unfortunate bounce.
Igben. Yeah, line changes again for the Lions.
Well, God's power falling a little short there.
Is that blasphemy?
Well,
blasphemy. Got to rip my shirt off. Oh, my gosh. John Cookman.
I can't help what his name is.
And Marcus Price rips one out.
And it stays with the Crusaders. A questionable call.
Burnside, take a look here. Let's see. Burnside pops it, and it did touch the left hand of Price last. So a turnover for the Lions. Dawson in the corner, guarded by Alexander. 5:45 remaining. Out to Igben. Burnside, three-pointer. Price puts a hand out. Short. Martain. Walters on him. Fights through a pick into the paint. A floater, too strong. Burnside offensive glass. No good. And a whistle. And we're going to keep it right here, called against Jonathan Walter, his first. Both teams have 10. Both will shoot two the rest of the way at the stripe.
Again, the poor shooting percentage by the Crusaders is just keeping this ball game close.
And that was a ticky-tack foul. I'm getting on your bandwagon now. I shouldn't do that, but that was a ticky-tack foul. Walter barely touched, if he did, the ball.
Yeah.
And yet Burnside will convert a pair. Alexander.
Maybe they're trying to even it out, I guess.
We'll cross the timeline. Guarded by Martain. Walter for three. Corner ball.
Ooh.
Short. No good. Gets his own rebound. Stops and pops again. This one is good. From 14 feet out. Elbow extended. Puts the lead back to one for the Lions. And the crowd's on their feet here at the Schaefer Center. They want to see these Lions pull away, break away, maybe get to that 5-7 point lead by halftime. And another whistle will send Burnside, Miles Burnside, back to the stripe. The 6'5 senior from Houston already has a pair of free throws, looking for point number 3 and 4 here. That is Marcus Price's second foul in the first half. Into the game is number 13, Jehoshua Walls, and number 20, Yvonne Rangel Uribe. Under 5 to play. We're knotted at 27 apiece. Rashad, harassed by Dawson, gets it over to wide open Walter for three.
Beautiful shot.
In the groove now, baby. Walter.
Walter getting on track.
Yes, sir. He's got 7. And a turnover looking for Rangel Uribe, gives the ball back over to SAGU. Walter, you know, he is the definitive streaky shooter. It's like he scores in bunches.
Well, I would say he's only streaky shooter when he's really in the perimeter mode. But you can count on John Walter to be 90% accurate around the hoop. He's so solid. So yeah, when little wild shot there. Oh, great pass.
Put back is no good. I think we'll send
Marcus Price to the line.
They're gonna call it against.
I didn't see it get reported.
Against Gentry.
Was there a foul reported? There's no foul reported. That was a violation.
Well, they flashed Gentry's number on the scoreboard the foul category. So,
oh, there it is.
It's a goaltending call we're hearing.
Yep.
Meanwhile, at the other end, it'll be Yvonne Rangel Uribe shoot a pair.
And that foul's on John Walter. Just his second.
Here it is again.
Yeah, he slapped the backboard, which is an automatic goaltend.
By Travis Martain. Lines up 4, 32-28, 4:04. Remaining in half number one, Rashad. Over to Gentry. Works at baseline and a foul on the floor, but that'll send Gentry to the line to shoot a pair. really like the pacing that Alexander sets the tone, even when he's working to get open and he's guarded by tonight Martain. He just finds a way to get that offense started, and that was the second pass. Gentry had a good look. I just think Rashad has become a mini version of Dominic Rambo, really creating a lot of energy and open looks for the Lions. As you see, the bench scoring 7 for DCC, 14 for Lions off the bench. That's no surprise. Points in the paint, pretty even. Second chance points, dead even. Points off turnovers, John. Look at that one. 15-7 in favor of the Crusaders.
And the Crusaders have shot maybe 10% or made 10% of the shots taken off of those turnovers.
They made that one.
Just imagine what this score would be if they had 50%.
Martain with the 3 from the corner. Gentry works baseline, stops, in trouble. Underneath the Adoy, over to Feimster, quickly to Tyler Guidry. Feimster wants it back, gets it back, turns, spins, in trouble.
Travel.
And a travel called against Feimster. He was double, maybe triple teamed. And a great job by the Crusaders to keep their feet and just keep those arms right in front. Really gave Feimster no vision to find an open man. Lines up just 2, 3:20 remaining. And DCC is giving the Lions all they can handle here at home. Burnside, no good. Adoy rips it out, on up ahead. Gentry tips to himself, to Feimster.
Travel.
And they're going to call Feimster for the travel. A nice tip pass from Gentry to Feimster, but he got his feet just kind of
it looked awkward. I don't know that it was a real travel, but it looked awkward.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, he took two steps.
Too many steps
right before he went into his stride. He needed a dribble.
What that is, John, for me, my perspective, it's him knowing he's probably 8 to 9 feet away from the basket, so he's thinking ahead, I got to get in position to have a good layup, and so he was trying to calibrate his final step, and in so doing, traveled on the way to the basket.
Well, the Lions have not taken care of the basketball, being very reckless, very careless with the basketball.
And Feimster.
Third time.
Gets the bucket that time, and he'll go to the line.
It was a great fundamental low post move by Caleb Feimster, and that's what he does well. Under control.
Got the contact with his beard. His face took one for the team. As he leans in and gets the foul. A chance to extend the lead to 5 with 2:34 remaining. Here at the Schaefer Center, you see the 3-point shot comparison, 44% for the Lions.
Oh, rare miss by Caleb Feimster.
25% for Crusaders. Rashad's got to be careful. Tyler now. It's the first time we've seen Tyler and Rashad on the court together at the same time, so Bostic kind of mixing up those line changes now, John.
Yep, and he's trying to find a combination that will work with speed. And while Tyler Guidry is not the fastest player by any means on the roster, his experience gives him the ability to be elusive. And Tyler is a very efficient player. So he minimizes his steps where he might not be as quick. He knows where to be. And as you saw right there, put him in the right place for a good steal.
He told me last year, I invite the double team. I want to be double team because then I know there's a man open. So he's not afraid to put himself in position as the Crusaders score, put himself in position to be in trouble, to quickly get out of trouble to benefit his teammates. And because, like I said, he knows where to be with the ball, how to handle the ball in traffic. Alexander inside the Feimster now. Nice spin move. Oh, a nice move as he slices through a pair of defenders. Best move of the night inside for the Lions.
Well, Caleb Feimster digging a well there and inviting his...
And it should be a charge. No, they're going to call a block on Mitchell. Mitchell had position.
Very close.
Wow, let's take a look at that
close.
One. Oh, he was moving. No, his right foot
He had
moving.
No feet set.
Yeah,
he was
that's
not
a good
planted.
Call. I stand corrected. You can't, once you plant, you got to keep those feet on the ground. He didn't do it. And that's That's Mitchell's second foul. Free throw is good. Lions now up just by five.
This is an interesting lineup for Boswick, because this is I would categorize this group of five as being maybe the slowest five that he could put out on the floor at any one time. You know, Rashad has a little bit of speed, but he's not the quickest man out there. He is with this five, but
how about the fast pass inside? And a nice inside pass to Mitchell, and a travel again called against Mitchell off a great pair of passes. First it was Guidry to Feimster, and then Feimster with a dish to Mitchell, whistled for the travel.
Yeah. They're going to more of a half-court game, trying to take a little bit of speed out of this game, which I think is a great idea by Coach Boswick. He's got to find a way to temper the speed of this game. And he knows if the Crusaders get hot at all, I mean, just.
And here's a steal up ahead, Gentry, Alexander. He misses the putback, misses the layup, I should say, and then Feimster tried to bail him out, and Rashad not happy with himself at all.
Tired, man. I'm just telling you, I see these guys are winded. They are tired. They cannot wait for halftime.
18 turnovers for SAGU, and you know Boswick is going to let them have it at halftime.
But this has been a good move, a good coaching move by Coach Boswick to try something a little different. Let's not try to run with them necessarily unless it's off of a turnover just like they had. But instead, come up, get a half-court set. Let's run some low-post action and try to get these guys in foul trouble.
First free throw, no good. Second one is good. Lines up five, 1:07 remaining. Now they'll instill the full court press. And Gentry likes to steal the ball. And now Guidry, did he walk? Was that a 10-second? It's a 10-second violation, just what the Lions needed. Got it at just the right time. Turnover.
And in college basketball, you have to secure possession across the half-court line to be able to stop the count. And the ball was over in time. They just had not secured possession.
Inbound underneath the basket. Feimster gets it into Guidry. 27 on the shot clock. Back to Feimster. Great position. Fighting for
jump ball.
Some space and
possession arrow at Dallas Christian.
Yeah, they'll get it back. Tied up Feimster as he spun into the paint.
This is a very important 44 seconds. I like the move to go to the full court press or three-quarter court press. Make sure these guys don't handle the ball very well. So SAGU's created a lot of turnovers themselves.
Dawson into the paint. And a charge called against Dawson as he pushed off Guidry.
Gotta love Guidry.
Oh, yeah, he lowered his shoulder.
Very efficient with his footsteps and staying in front.
Guidry took the brunt of that one. 15 remaining, shot clock is off. Gentry works left over to Alexander. Back into the paint, skips it over to Swearingen, and he does not get the whistle. Gets his own rebound, puts it back up and in. Swearingen just hung around. Knew he was going to miss it, and a long shot at halftime is nearly goes in. How about Swearingen with the strong move to the basket for the pass from Gentry? Knew he was going to miss it and just was hanging around, and the ball came right back into his lap and put it back up and in.
Well, that was a fantastic play by the freshman to stay inside and realize where they are in the game, watching and never saying die.
If we show that again, look at Swearingen's eyes. If we see that again, the pass from Alexander, watch his eyes. He never takes his eyes off, never. And then he says, okay, I'll take it, because 13 jumped early, did walls, and right there on the spot, Swearingen takes care of business. We're at halftime, folks, 42-35. Don't go anywhere. It's going to be a fun one, and let's go down out of the field on the court now and check in with Adam Ferguson. Adam?
Thanks, Rob. I'm here with assistant coach Garrett Jones. Now, coach, you have a tightly contested first half here. You pulled away a little bit there towards the end. Now, the scoring has been spread out between almost all your players, which is kind of opposite what we saw the other night against John Brown. Now, what do you have to say about this first half?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, this year, I think we're going to have a lot of balanced scoring. It's always good when a guy gets hot, but it's going to be a group effort on our end. You know, they're a scrappy bunch. They've played a lot of good teams this year, so they're not going to come in here and be scared or anything like that. And it was a good half. You know, they're quick. It's a tough matchup because they got five guards out there all the time. So we'll make some adjustments and come out second half and play better.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Back to you, Rob.
Thanks, Coach Jones. Thanks, Adam. Any final thoughts going into halftime, John, as the Lions did finally get that little cushion? They had to lead at 7, but it feels like about 1.
Well, and it is 1 with this team. I can tell you right now that the score very easily could be lopsided in favor of Dallas Christian. They're not very efficient with the way they shoot the basketball, and it's not leading to effective scoring. They're producing a lot of turnovers, so their defense is definitely their biggest asset. But if they come out and they just get – they take it from 10%, as we see right now, the field goal percentage. So 26%
wow.
against 50%, and they're only up seven points.
That's 2 3-pointers and a free throw. That's nothing.
Yeah. You're looking at a very lopsided game if – Dallas Christian shoots just only as good as SAGU. We're talking about 70-42 at that point.
Both teams have got off essentially 40 shots for the Crusaders and 39 shots. The shots are similar. It's just a completion, and they've just got to put those through. Free throws in major, major advantage for the Crusaders right now. Rebounds, Lions have the edge there.
And the three-point percentage is definitely in favor of the Lions. So. You can't for 1 minute think, well, we got a 7-point lead in the halftime. That 7-point lead could evaporate almost instantly. And I would say these guys are going to come out and fight extremely hard to chip into that lead quickly. But I think that we may see Coach Boswick stick with where he left off and try to get back in and slow the tempo down to a half-court type of game, get the ball down to his bigs, and see what they can provide. They're working the ball. If they slow it down, get them down, let's make that defense work a little bit harder on our side of the court, and hopefully that will tire them down on their side of the court.
And with 18, 19 turnovers, that's about 1 a minute, and you know Coach Boswick is going to remind them of that, and they've got to get that number down if they want to have a chance to stay in this game. You see the assist, 8-1 in favor of the Lions. Blocks, same. Steals in favor of the Crusaders. There's your turnover ratio right there, basically. And team fouls dead even. So we will be back with second half action here at the Schaefer Center. Your halftime score, 42-35 in favor of the Lions. Stay with us here on the SAGU Sports Network.